Greetings, friends. David Marks here. Adobe Photoshop Lightroom Classic version 11 expands our image editing capabilities with a new feature called masking. Masking means targeting changes to one specific region of your image without accidentally changing anything else. In today's tutorial, I'm going to dig into how this works with the incredible new Select Sky command. Let's jump right into my Lightroom Classic catalog and let's get started. On the screen right now is an image that I captured one evening here in Montana. Now, before I started recording this video, I did everything that I could to polish up my raw image using all of the global controls that we have here inside of Lightroom Classic. I'm pleased with the overall image at this point, but the sky here lacks punch. So, to fix that, I'm going to open up the brand new masking panel, and then I'm going to tap on the new Select Sky command. When I activate this new AI sky detection tool, Lightroom is going to try to isolate what it thinks is the sky in this photo for me. When the Select Sky algorithm is done, it will cover over much of my photo with a red overlay. I want to point out that we are seeing this red overlay right now because A, my overlay mode is currently set to the color overlay option, and B, I currently have the Show Overlay command active. I bet you know this by now, but when we're working with masking in Lightroom, this red zone, the overlay, it indicates the region that we are about to change if I move any of these sliders over here inside of the masking panel. Since I want to add some drama into that sky, I'm going to bring the exposure down. I'm going to bring the contrast up. I'll brighten up the whites. I'll bring down the highlights. And then I'm going to add a touch of dehaze and a bit of saturation to make things more colorful. Perhaps adding a touch of additional blue might help here too. For that, I can slide the temperature slider down a tiny little bit. Now I think this sky looks good. Let me tap on the little light switch at the bottom of the masking panel a few times so you can see what a difference these changes have made on this image. Wow, that's amazing. And what is the most impressive to me is the way that Lightroom automatically masked out all of the trees at the far horizon, and it knew to exclude that big cliff wall on the right. One of the best ways to illustrate just how well the bitmask mapping here has worked is to change the overlay mode to the image on black and white setting. But when I flicked that light switch on and off, it deselected this mask. That's why the pin is now a little black dot. So, to see what I've done here, I need to click on this pin first so that it becomes active again. Now, I can come down here and change the color overlay mode to image on black and white, and then when I enable show overlay, you can see that the parts of this image that are in color are the parts that this masking layer is changing. And obviously, the part in black and white is the part where the mask is having no effect. I could call it quits right now, since we've already turned this into this. But you know, since this mask is so precise, we might as well use its opposite to add a little more punch into everything but the sky. The easiest way to flip this mask over so that the next one will change the land instead of the sky is to put the cursor up here inside of the masking panel. When I move the cursor up here, these three little dots will appear. And if I tap on them, then I'll get a flyout menu. About midway down in this menu is the option to duplicate this mask. When I do this, my sky is going to look way too dark, because at first, this new layer, the duplicate layer, it's using the same mask and the same exact settings as the first one I created. If I click down here, though, on the invert button, then I can instantly flip this mask over so that the cliffs and the lake, everything but the sky, is now selected on this layer. Next, I need to double-click on the word effect here at the top of the masking sliders to reset all these controls. Now, I'm going to slightly increase the exposure. I'll bring up the shadows. I'll add some texture, a little clarity. And with that, I bet my foreground has a bit more pop. Let's see how we did when I made these changes to the cliff and lake only. To see what I've accomplished on this masking layer, I need to move the cursor back up here. And now, if I tap on this little eyeball beside this mask, I can enable or disable the changes that we made on this masking group only. I love it. Now, to see what we've accomplished using both of these mask groups, I can tap on this little light switch, either here at the top of the masking panel or down here at the bottom. With all of these masks turned off, you can see where we started today. And when I enable the masking panel again, this is what my photo looks like now, using two simple masks. This is fantastic, and I'm completely delighted with the result that we've achieved here using the new Select Sky command. Before I sign off, I must warn you that working with the Select Sky command is not always going to be this easy. I intentionally picked an image for this demo where Lightroom really nailed it. Be aware that there are going to be times when Classic does not select the whole sky automatically, or when the algorithm chooses more than you actually want. I'll cover what to do in those cases and additional mask cleanup skills in my more advanced tutorials. But for now, let me end by saying wow once again. When this command works well, like it did for us with this image, the new Select Sky command is a blessing for landscape photographers like me. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.